The Kuiper Belt is a disc-shaped region located beyond Neptune, stretching from approximately 3255 astronomical units, AU, away from the Sun, with Earth being 1 AU. It is believed that this remote region is inhabited by numerous icy bodies, each larger than 100 kilometers or 62 miles, and an estimated trillion or more comets. Here are 11 facts you need to know about the Kuiper Belt. First things first, number 11. We've already made a video about the Kuiper Belt. This is only the second part of a collection of interesting facts about the subject. If you haven't already, make sure to click the link provided in the description to watch the initial installment. Number 10. The first KB object was discovered in 1992. Pluto, a dwarf planet, stands out as one of the more recognizable objects within the expansive Kuiper Belt. Comets originating from this region complete their orbits around the Sun in under 200 years, aligning closely with the plane in which the majority of planets orbit. These Kuiper Belt objects, or KBOs, believed to be remnants from the solar system's formation roughly 4.6 billion years ago, gained attention relatively recently. However, it wasn't until 1992 that the first Kuiper Belt object, distinct from Pluto, was finally discovered. That year, astronomers Dave Jewett and Jane Liu challenged the notion of an empty outer solar system. Their diligent efforts, beginning in 1987, involved a thorough survey of the skies beyond Neptune using the University of Hawaii's 2.2-meter telescope. After 5 years of intermittent searching, they successfully identified a distinct reddish speck located 44 astronomical units from the Sun, even more distant than Pluto. While Jewett, University of Hawaii, and Liu, UC Berkeley, initially wished to name their discovery Smiley, it was officially catalogued as 1992 QB1. But here's the interesting part. Were you aware that we had visited the Kuiper Belt physically even prior to 1992? Number 9. We have been to the KB in 1983. NASA's Pioneer 10 spacecraft became the first to venture into the Kuiper Belt area in 1983. Surpassing Neptune's orbit. However, it did not explore any of the icy worlds within this region, since only Pluto had been identified at the time. Voyager 2 later visited Neptune's moon Triton in 1989, and Cassini visited Saturn's moon Phoebe in 2004, potentially originating from the Kuiper Belt and escaping its grasp. The initial spacecraft to truly investigate a celestial body in the Kuiper Belt was NASA's New Horizons, which conducted a close flyby of Pluto and its moons in July of 2015. Subsequently, New Horizons also passed by a second Kuiper Belt object named Arrokoth on January 1, 2019. Remarkably, images captured during this encounter unveiled a peculiar reddish-colored object with a dual-lobe structure reminiscent of a partially flattened snowman. The unexpected shape of this object, unlike anything previously observed, proved to be the most astonishing revelation of the flyby. Number 8. Arrokoth can be found in the KB. Upon closer examination, the object that initially resembled a snowman is actually a combination of two smaller objects that have been fused together for billions of years. These celestial bodies have been adrift in space, patiently awaiting for us to observe them. Arrokoth's surface has a uniform appearance and exhibits a reddish hue commonly found among objects in the Kuiper Belt. The absence of significant impact craters and the smooth texture suggest minimal alteration since its inception. For this reason, postulate that Arrokoth is a primitive entity, preserving its original form since the early stages of the solar system. Its composition likely encompasses a mixture of volatile ices, organic compounds, and fundamental building blocks that can offer valuable insights into the conditions and processes that shaped our solar system. Number 7. The KB hosts the farthest object from the Sun, far, far out. In 2018, astronomers made a groundbreaking announcement about the discovery of the most distant resident within our solar system. This tiny dwarf planet, provisionally named 2018 VG18 and affectionately nicknamed Far Out by its discovery team, is situated at a distance 120 times farther from the Sun than Earth. Displaying a pinkish hue indicative of its icy composition, Farfarout boasts a diameter estimated at around 500 kilometers. However, the narrative took a magical turn in 2021 when a new revelation emerged, challenging Farfarout's title, named Farfarout. It surpassed its predecessor in distance. While Farfarout orbited the Sun at about 120 astronomical units, Farfarout broke the record at a staggering 140 AU. Farfarout, a Kuiper Belt object, is a truly singular object. While Pluto spans 1,400 miles or 2,380 kilometers in width, Farfarout is composed of two lobes, each measuring between 6 and 9 miles or 10 to 15 kilometers across. The specifics of Farfarout's orbit remain unknown, with the intriguing possibility that it could be influenced by the still hypothesized Planet 9 or Planet X. These larger bodies are postulated to be concealed within the distant Oort cloud, situated beyond the Kuiper Belt, adding an element of mystery to the outer reaches of our cosmic neighborhood. Objects like Farfarout are believed to be remnants of the solar system's formation and provide valuable insights into the processes of planetary development. The accretion of smaller objects into larger formations, frozen in place over time, offers a glimpse into the intricate dance of celestial bodies. Beyond mere trivia, entities such as Farfarout might offer clues to more substantial phenomena concealed in the distant corners of the solar system. This pattern extends beyond our solar system. Exoplanetary systems form through similar processes, and Kuiper belts are prevalent throughout the universe. We'll delve into this shortly. And stay with us. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Number 6. Eris, KBO that could have been a planet. In July of 2005, scientists made a significant finding, a Kuiper Belt object initially believed to be around 10% larger than Pluto. This object, temporarily named 2003 UB313 and later called Eris, follows an orbit around the Sun that takes approximately 560 years, with its distance ranging from about 38 to 98 astronomical units. For comparison, Pluto's orbit spans from 29 to 49 AU. Eris possesses a small moon called Dysnomia. Recent measurements have revealed that Eris is slightly smaller than Pluto. The discovery of Eris, a celestial body that orbits the Sun and is comparable in size to Pluto, which was considered the ninth planet at the time, prompted astronomers to ponder whether Eris should be recognized as the 10th planet. However, in 2006, the International Astronomical Union introduced a new class of celestial objects named dwarf planets, which included Pluto, Eris, and the asteroid Ceres. Number 5. The KB hosts Cubewanos. Not everybody knows that the Kuiper Belt is home to a peculiar group of celestial neighbors known as Cubewanos. Cubewanos are characterized by their relatively small size and elongated orbits. Now, these space rocks have two types, hot and cold. If you're a hot Cubewanos, your orbit is more likely to be stretched out. Plus, you tilt a bit, adding a cool twist to your dance moves. On the other hand, the cold Cubewanos are the calm ones. Their orbits are more rounded, like they're doing a simple, easygoing dance. They don't tilt much, keeping things stable and relaxed. Number 4. The KB has twins, Antipholus and Antipholus. Now, speaking of Cubewanos, the researchers at the Canada-France Ecliptic Plane Survey have closely observed one of them for 7 years. As implied by its namesake, 2001 QW322, it was discovered in 2001. However, what wasn't evident from these names is that in 2001, QW322 is a binary asteroid, denoted as 2001 QW322A and 2001 QW322B. Dissatisfied with the conventional designation, astronomers have given the pair a more imaginative and fitting name, Antipholus and Antipholus. Yes, they gave them the same name. Crazy move? Not at all. The reason for their identical names lies in the near-identical size of 2001 QW322A and B, as discerned by Kuiper Belt hunters. Luminosity measurements indicate a mere 1 to 5% variation in brightness for each, confirming their nearly identical dimensions of 62 miles or 100 kilometers in diameter and similar reflectiveness. However, their twin status alone doesn't earn them a spot on the list. What truly sets them apart is the peculiar distance at which they orbit each other. With an astonishing separation of 125,000 kilometers, Antipholus and Antipholus take 25 to 30 years to complete a single orbit. This vast distance, considering the relatively small size of the objects, is a remarkable phenomenon. It's been this way for a billion years, and projections suggest they'll endure for another billion. Nevertheless, the inevitable gravitational disruption will eventually lead to their permanent separation. Number 3. Is it safe for a spacecraft to cross the KB? The possibility of the Kuiper Belt preventing humans from venturing beyond the solar system has always sparked curiosity. However, rest assured that this is not the case. Consider this scenario. The average distance within the asteroid belt, which is closer to the Sun compared to the Kuiper Belt, is similar to the distance between Earth and the Moon. Hence, there is ample space for spacecraft created by humans to navigate safely among the asteroids in the region. While there may be an estimated billion unidentified objects in the Kuiper Belt, its vast three-dimensional expanse implies that the average distance between these objects is likely to be closer than in the asteroid belt. In simpler terms, if we could find a way to traverse the distances within a reasonable time frame, neither the asteroid belt nor the Kuiper Belt will hinder our journey beyond the solar system. Number 2. The KB is not unique to our solar system. Similar to the abundance of confirmed exoplanets, the presence of structures resembling the Kuiper Belt in our solar system is not exclusive. These structures, known as debris disks, have been identified around approximately 20% of stars. Interestingly, debris disks were discovered even before the first exoplanet. They consist of dust remnants remaining after the formation of planets within the initial 10 million years of a star's existence. These dust particles absorb high-energy ultraviolet light from their host star and emit light at longer wavelengths, such as infrared. Consequently, the overall system appears brighter in these specific wavelengths. When there is a substantial concentration of these particles, they become visible to our telescopes. Although debris disks are widespread in stars, their sizes and shapes vary greatly. The unique characteristics of our Sun's Kuiper Belt, including its size, morphology, and role in delivering water, set it apart. Capturing photographs provides one of the most direct forms of evidence for the existence of debris disks. However, photographing debris disks in visible light or near infrared poses challenges. In these wavelengths, the dust particles and debris disks only scatter a small portion of the star's light, making it difficult to discern the disk. Nevertheless, astronomers have developed techniques to image debris disks, such as employing coronagraphs to block and minimize the central star's light, using another star as a reference to eliminate the overwhelming starlight, and observing these systems in different light polarization directions. Thanks to these observational approaches, coupled with advancements in data reduction methods, astronomers have successfully captured images of more than 40 debris disks in scattered light by 2018. Number 1. Astronomers have found the closest KB analog. Among the imaged debris disks, one stands out for its resemblance to our Kuiper Belt in both size and shape. Recently, a team of astronomers led by Bin Ren from the Johns Hopkins University utilized the Hubble Space Telescope and the Gemini Planet Imager (GPI) at the Gemini Observatory to capture the first high-resolution scattered light images of the debris disk system surrounding the star HD191089. The star itself is a younger counterpart to our Sun, approximately 200 times younger and 10% hotter. The system features a ring centered at 46 AU with a width of around 25 AU. Making it the closest Kuiper Belt analog discovered to date. Additionally, a large-scale fainter diffuse halo extends up to 640 AU, equivalent to 21 times the orbit of Neptune. As the closest Kuiper Belt analog, the question arises, is the HD191089 ring a true counterpart to our Kuiper Belt in all aspects? The answer hinges on a fundamental inquiry. Does HD191089 harbor a shepherding planet that exerts a shaping influence akin to Neptune in our solar system? This remains uncertain, and further measurements are required. However, based on observations of the inner and outer edges of the ring, Scientists concluded that if these edges are periodically perturbed and shaped by a planet, it likely resides at 30 AU, an intriguing parallel to Neptune's role in shaping our own Kuiper Belt. Quite remarkable, isn't it? That's all for this video. What would you like us to cover next? Feel free to share your thoughts in the comments below, and stay tuned for our next videos. I'll see you soon on the channel.